Hey folks, what's up? Ashish here for Doublepeak's Box, and we have this carbon titanium Windows phone. And in this video, we're going to do the gaming review. So we have asphalt it as usual, and you should get to see the loading time and the kind of reflection the phone gives while gaming and game performance. Now, I've played a lot of games on this, including Asphalt 8, Airborne, Temple Run 2, and all the other casual games. And it runs pretty much smooth even on a 512 MB RAM. Now, the real trouble is it's slow. It's like you saw how much time it took for loading, and you will see even, you know, more how much time it takes to load when it goes into a gameplay mode. So there you go, I'll just start it, and there you go. So you will see the kind of loading time is high. The good thing is it doesn't heat a lot, and you know, it doesn't make you feel like hot oven, so that's kind of good. It does heat up a little bit, but that's okay. That's with every other phone on the, you know, on the road, so nothing to worry about from that perspective. So you can see that high loading time was there. Now the phone is only a 4-inch phone. It's WVGA. It's around 840x480p, so don't expect a lot of high graphics, but the performance wise is perfectly smooth, except for the loading time, like I told you just a few seconds before. So I'm just going to race and see how it goes. Now while playing, I've played this game on like every other Lumia Windows phone, so you know, I can feel the pain for a high-end user, but since high-end user is not going to buy, so I'm taking my bar down to on Lumia 530 or even on Lumia 630, and they are very similar graphics, so you will get similar graphic result as in 530, because hardware, I guess, it's almost the same except for few things here and there. But that's kind of wreck you're looking at. Pretty fast when it comes to wrecks, so not a problem. I wrecked it again. Now I don't see a lot of frame rates or frame drops or similar stuff, so you wouldn't be worrying much about that anyways. So it does work well, except for the fact that you might have to work a little harder to keep up in the game if you don't know. So that's the kind of graphics you're looking at. If I give you a closer look on how it's running, so you can see the graphic and the color changes and the amount of reflection on the phone. So expect something similar. At least performance wise, the phone doesn't have a problem at all during the gameplay, which is kind of pretty important, because if it gets slow while you're actually playing the game, it's kind of annoying. Was a new style, I didn't know about it. And yeah, while playing the game, the speakers are does okay, but don't expect something very solid or Dolby effort, because the speakers are not really that good. You can see that in our full review. The speakers like blast out like anything when it comes to, you know, full volume and all. So don't expect much there, but overall a decent experience for people who are looking at this price point. So folks, if you have any questions and all, please let me know, and probably if there is something of a huge demand, I'll do another video. But overall, it's a decent phone for gaming perspective. It doesn't heat up at all. Graphics are low because the screen resolution is low, otherwise not a problem. So thanks for watching, and if you like the video, do let us know by liking the comment. Wow, that was nice. By liking the comment and you know, sharing it with your friends who are looking to buy this phone. Thanks for watching.